good. Buffaloes, if they expect to win this game, they're going to have to start sinking those free throws, Will, as Scott missed that free throw. Jordan Holman missed her last two free throws. And those are just free points if you can sink them. So Scott goes back to the free throw line. Second shot off the front of the rim. No good. Ellison pulls down the rebound. And the Lady Rebels have a chance to tie or take the lead here on this possession. Lawless with the basketball, trying to get it inside. It's going to be knocked off of Hugo. Silo is going to keep the basketball. Good interior defense there by Scott and Jordan Holman knocking it away.
Well, we're going to try to go live on our Payne Media Group YouTube account. It's up and running right now. We'll try to share a Facebook link later to that, but once again, we're live up on our Payne Media Group Facebook page. It's going to be down, but our Payne Media Group YouTube is going to be up tonight.
All right, good deal. Been having a lot of trouble here inside the cinder block and sheet metal gym here at Silo. It's our first time here as Silo works the ball around. You never know what you're going to get when you go to a new place. We've never been here before, never broadcasted before, had some difficulties. Think we have it worked out now to where you may be able to see some video. So
on our YouTube channel, look for Payne Media Group.
All right, Payne Media Group on the YouTube channel. And if you can get that, man, you can watch it on the big screen. Be a
Absolutely.
Great broadcast for you. So Silo's still working the ball around. They're down by two right now. Three-point shot up and in. Nothing but string music there for Midgley there, number 21, as she drains it from the corner. Silo takes the lead, 28-27. Buffaloes with the basketball. Asia Jordan has it. Gets it over in the corner to Jordan Holman. Looking down low, nothing there. Gets it back to Donna Akins, over to Zion Beals as she gets the ball knocked away, gets it right back, and then out top to Jordan Holman. We're going to reset the offense here with 3 minutes to go here. Actually, 3 minutes, 15 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Asia Jordan's shot in the paint is no good. They're going to be a jump ball, and Buffalo's going to keep possession on the possession arrow. So Asia Jordan is going to take it out underneath. Buffalo's waiting on substitutions to come in for Silo. Silo doesn't understand that it wasn't their basketball as Harmon has to retreat back up. They do finally pack it in and allow action to continue. Bell getting set to check in for the Lady Rebels. Kadrin Scott, nothing there. And then Jordan Holman shuffles her feet. She's going to go toward the paint. She travels. So Silo gets the basketball back, and they have a one-point lead.
My Rock 96.5, home to Hugo Buffaloes in 21. And 2:58 to go here in the third. It's 27-28. Silo with the lead.
Silo with the basketball. They're going to try to get the offense set up. That's going to be Harmon working it at the top of the key. Pressured by Akins. They pushed Akins down. No call there. Coach Scott not real happy about it. And so the ball goes out of bounds off of Silo. Asia Jordan with a tough defense there, knocking it away. Buffalo's going to get the basketball back as Jordan Holman going to take it out in front of the Silo bench. Gets it into Asia Jordan. As so they have Donna Akins in the fold along with Scott and Zion Beals. Scott looking to get it inside. Nothing there. Working it around. Kadrin Scott has it. Nothing there. Back up top. It gets to Asia Jordan. She's going to try it, and we're going to have, looks like we're going to have a jump ball or a foul. One of the two. The referees are conferring.
Yeah, and they're going to take the ball out underneath the bucket there. 2:14 to play here in the third.
And we are going to have a foul. That's going to be on Harmon. Double zero.
They got that big, beautiful scoreboard up there and not using the fouls.
I know. That is a scoreboard operator error. Foul's going to be on Hugo. The shot was no good. Going up for the rebound. Going to have a loose ball foul on the coach's daughter, Will.
Well, I'd say this has flown by. We're already in the third quarter, 2:11 to go. Down by one, but the Buffalo is just a one steal away from getting this game back in control.
Yeah, just down by one right now, 28-27. Silo, they have Ellison with the basketball. She's looking to slow it down. Almost a five-second call. She gets it over to Bell. Silo working that mix-it-up offense, and then they get it down low to Harmon. back up top for a three-point shot. Looks like she shuffled her feet. No call. Nice block there by the Buffaloes. They come up with the basketball. Kadrin Scott has it across midcourt. Over to Asia Jordan. Her shot no good. Long rebound off the back of the rim goes to Silo. Harmon has it. Tries to penetrate. Nothing there. So she pulls it back out. She's going to be guarded by Bills. Bills lets her through, though, and she scores. Silo goes up by three.
Pretty athletic play there for Silo. She goes into the paint. There are three Buffaloes there, just couldn't keep them away from it.
Nice job there by Harmon, getting into the paint and scoring. Akins with the basketball. She's going to travel. She didn't know she wanted to shoot or pass.
and you've got to make a decision. You've got to make whether you want to go to the bucket or you want to pass the ball off. You can't have these turnovers here in the third.
Yeah, Coach Scott's going to try a different combination. Will he gets Woodard into the basketball game for Hugo. She's kind of a presence underneath. You know, she's got some muscle and rebounding ability. As she's going to try to front, that's going to be Bell. Shot in the corner off the mark. Woodard going for it. Akins going for it. And they're going to say Akins stepped out of bounds before she did get it to Woodard. It's going to go back to Silo.
Wow. You can't let those turnovers, go like that. You have an opportunity there. And you got to get that ball. You got to be able to put it back into bounds and give it to your player or doing to your teammates in order to get the ball back up the court.
So Silo is going to get to take it out over there on the far side. Having some trouble doing so. Finally get it in. They get it into the big girl. Ellison makes a nice pass, and the shot is up and good once again by McDonald as she gets it on the dish from Ellison. Ellison knocks it away there, trying to get it to Akins. Hugo's going to keep control of the basketball. They're down right now by five. This is their largest deficit of the night.
And, you know, you're thinking third quarter, third period, you want to get things under control, try to keep it within at least one or two buckets. See if we can't get a three-pointer here.
Yeah, Hugo does have the basketball. Akins has it. He gets it up top to Woodard, over in the corner to Jordan Holman. She's going to try to drive baseline into the paint, and she's going to be fouled. I'm going to say it's on the floor, though. I think it was when they called the foul when she split the defenders before she shot. That's going to go against Harmon. That's going to be her second foul. Jordan's going to take it out underneath the goal. The Buffaloes stack it up. They stacked it up on the wrong side, though. To get it over in the corner to Akins. Her three is off the back of the rim. No good. Outlet pass is stolen by Jordan Holman, and it's knocked out of bounds. Going to go over to Silo, though, as Silo gets a hand in there, and then Jordan Holman loses control of it. 7 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Silo going to take it out. They're going to try to do something long here. They do get it into Harmon. Harmon drives, dishes it off. Three-pointer is up, and it's an air ball. It's no good. Hugo is going to go to the fourth quarter. They're down right now, though, to the Lady Rebels, 32-27.
Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, Hugo, Oklahoma, salutes athletes of all types across the Red River Valley. Congratulations. Your hard work is paying off for you. That is what Ed Wallace Ford has learned over the last few years. A new location, 1700 East Jackson, better to serve you and more value than ever before. Built Ford tough? Come experience it yourself. Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, or online, edwallaceforofhugo.com.
First United, united to serve. There's a bank working hard for you all across the state. People helping to see you through. That's what makes United great. First United, united to serve. United, united to serve.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
My Rock 96.5, home of the Hugo Buffaloes in 2020 and 2021. Will Payne alongside Will Smith with you here in Silo. Here we go to the fourth. Buffaloes down 32-27.
Yeah, and the possession error right now, not their friend. Silo is going to start off the fourth quarter with the basketball on a five-point lead. Harmon has the basketball. She's going to be working on Zion Bills. Trying to get it in the corner to Lawless. She does. Lawless thinks about the three-pointer, pulls it back out, trying to get it down low to the big girl. She does, into the paint, knocked away. Nice job there by Jordan Holman. That's one of the advantages she has over the taller girl. She has the quickness into the paint, and a nice job there. We're going to have a jump ball. Hugo's going to get that on an awesome play there by Jordan Holman.
I tell you, the athleticism of Holman shows up, and that's what it's going to take here in the fourth in order to claw back into this one.
All right, so Zion Beals has the basketball. For the Lady Buffs right now, they're down 5, 7.5 to go in the basketball game. Woodard still in the game for the Buffaloes. Kadren Scott has it up top. She's patiently looking for somebody to pass it to. Gets it to Jordan Holman. Jordan Holman looks over at Woodard, decides to get it to Kadren Scott. She drives into the paint, kicks it out. Asia Jordan drives, and her shot is going to be blocked. It's corralled by Jordan Holman. She puts up the shot, no good. Had a travel there, not called. The shot is up, it's no good. Asia Jordan with the basketball, and she gets a nice defensive rebound for Hugo.
Well, that looked like a snowbird looking to make an easy layup there, and Buffaloes were able to get right back and play defense.
Three-pointer by Zion Beals, no good, and Jordan Holman with a loose ball foul.
Man, she went up there. I thought she was going to uncontested, and she ends up falling onto the ladies' silo rebel, but it looked like it was, you know, two different basketball players going up for the basketball. It was nobody with control.
Yeah, you're right. Silo gets it across midcourt. That's going to be Harmon. Gets a nice screen there from the big girl, Ellison. And she goes down low, gets it, loses control of it, picks it back up, puts it up and in. And anytime you can get it to Ellison down low, that's an easy two for Silo. They're up by 7 right now, 34-27.
Ellison, I have to tell you the story. A little family history with Southeastern.
Okay.
And maybe a little family history with a really good basketball player from Atoka.
Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, that's her niece.
They're a little bit related.
That's
huh?
her aunt.
Okay, why did she go to Atoka? Could Jay not recruit her?
Evidently, the sister lived in Silo.
That's unfortunate.
Yes, indeed.
Jay probably would have bought her a house.
Would have loved to have had her, no question. Anybody would love to have Allison on their basketball team. And Silo Rebels with the lead, 34-27 here in the fourth. A timeout on the court. We'll keep it right here. Will and Will back in Silo. Great to be back in a fairly, you know, close proximity when it comes to basketball.
Yeah, it is. You're talking about going an hour away. A fun time over here in Silo. You know, pretty straight shot. Just go past Durant a little bit. Take a right there at the little bitty green sign.
Yes. Yeah, you got to look. It's a little bitty sign that says Silo. Take a right. If not, you end up at Lake Texoma.
That's right, if you don't know where you're going. But the Buffaloes right now, down by 7 right now. They'll be next weekend, Will. Not this weekend. Not this weekend, but they'll be at the Jay McAdams Classic over there in Atoka, boys and girls action next weekend. So that'll be a Thursday, Friday, Saturday deal. Should be some good basketball and another chance for the Buffaloes, both boys and girls, to see some really good teams. So Hugo inbounds the basketball. Asia Jordan has it. She gets the inbound pass. She's hung up, though, right now, as she has to get it quickly to Akins. It's knocked away and stolen by Ellison. Just not a very good pass there by Asia Jordan as she turns it over. So Harmon gets the basketball. She is at midcourt, drives to the left, drives back out. Akins is all over her. They're trying to get it inside to Ellison. And why wouldn't you, man? She's been a monster tonight as the Rebels have it. Working it around, working some clock, too. Just 5 minutes, 40 seconds to go. Looks like they're going to get it to Ellison. She dribbles around a little bit, gives it up, gives it to Lawless. Lawless, who is the daughter of softball coach Marty Lawless. He's originally from Rattan, by the way. He's brought a state championship to Silo. They never could win one. Always in the same class as Dale, Will, and they're very tough.
That is very difficult, absolutely.
So congratulations to them. Trying to get one in basketball here because they have a really good girls basketball team. And Coach Scott very upset he didn't get the five-second call there as he just stomps off down there to the other end line. As Silo working the ball around. They're under 5 minutes to go there. They get it inside to Ellison. Her shot's no good. Buffaloes control the rebound. Nice defense there by Jordan Holman. They get it inside to Kadren Scott. Her shot off the back of the rim, no good. Buffaloes have nobody there offensively to get that rebound as Silo comes down with it, and then we're going to have a foul. I believe that's going to go against Jordan Holman.
Lady Buffs just kind of out of sync here in the third and fourth, and Silo's kind of walking away from them right now. They had the lead in the second. Kind of went into halftime feeling pretty good. And the second half, Silo come down, kind of clamped down and taking advantage of the turnovers.
Yeah, I felt really good after the second period. But third and fourth period, Silo has really came on, made a couple of adjustments there at halftime, and just said basically, hey, let's don't play their game. Let's play our game. They have and done a good job. And they've kept what they've done, which the block by Ellison there, they have kept Ellison in the paint. And she's just controlled that down low. Buffaloes have not gotten any easy shots, any buckets down low. So right now the Buffaloes down by 7, 4 minutes, 14 seconds. Ellison has it, scores down into the paint, up and in. Silo with another bucket, and they're up by 9. Their largest lead of the game, they lead 36-27. Jordan with the basketball over to Aikens. Three-point shot, no good. Cadron Scott gets the rebound, kicks it back up. Jordan Holman's going to reset the offense. Baseline drive by Asia Jordan. She tries to dish it off. She throws it out of bounds. So in doing so, turns it over for the Buffaloes, and Silo with an offensive opportunity to add to their lead.
Will, if you're Lady Buffs, if Coach Scott, what do you do here? How do you clamp down, try to get some quick turnovers, get the ball back into the girls' hands and maybe do some transition buckets?
Well, I think what they got to do, the problem is they can't score. I mean, they got Aiken. She is ice cold now. And I jinxed her. She said that. She sinks a 18-foot jumper. It goes up and in. But what they've got to do, Will, and they didn't do it on this possession, they've got to go end-to-end and play that press defense.
And if they can get that done, Silo's done a great job of being able to break it and kind of move the ball around a little bit.
But thinking about a five-second call, and we're going to have a travel call. And I think what he did is he made up for that guy over there not calling the five-second call.
I think he might have been right there, the quick title, quick one. So if you
I didn't see any of this. I saw some of this.
Yeah. He should have been counting. He counted to 7. So if you can get the bucket here, that'll bring
Maybe
it within.
He got stumped at 3.
Yeah.
I don't know. But anyway, kudos to this official for the make good. Trying to get it down low to Jordan Holman. Her shot is up. No good. Gets her own rebound.
Nice.
Puts it up and in over the trees. Gets fouled. Gets an opportunity to go to the free throw line. And pull the game back down manageable to a 4-point game.
All right. So she's going to get the plus one here.
Hopefully.
Maybe you sink this one. You do get it within 4, 2:54. You're only 2 transition buckets away, but you got to play some defense. And we've struggled of getting the ball back quickly from Silo.
I don't think there's any question. Free throw is no good. And that's boy, that hurts, Will. You add up all the free throws Hugo missed, and you know, could have been a different story. Almost a steal there by Jordan Holman. Yes, cross-court pass there. Silo has the basketball. And we're going to have a whistle on the play. Looked like Asia Jordan's going to be called for the foul.
Wow. It was a good, strong move underneath the bucket for the Lady Rebels. Did a great job just kind of going in and pushing the ball up there. Didn't quit on the play. Fell through, and it didn't happen to just fall through the bucket. Give it the 2 points. 38-31. Silo with the lead here in the fourth.
So the shot is up. It's no good. Silo gets the offensive board, but it's blocked and stolen by Cadron Scott. Quick pass down court to Zion Bills. The Buffaloes know they need points, and they need them in a hurry, down 7 right now. Aikens has it, trying to get it down low. It's knocked out of bounds. Not out of bounds, but it's knocked away. Silo comes up with the basketball. Get it over to Lawless there, number 1. And she throws it away. It's going to go out of bounds. It's going to go off of Hugo as Zion Bills got a hand in there and knocked it away. So we're going to have a timeout. Silo wants a timeout. So we'll take a timeout here on My Rock 96.5.
Little Dixie, Community Action Agency Incorporated, helping people help themselves. The Court-Appointed Special Advocate, or CASA, is a program that recruits and trains volunteers to be advocates for abused and neglected children as they move through the court system. For more information about CASA, call 580-298-2921. And for a listing of all programs and services, go to www.littledixie.org.
First Bank Hugo, this is Wade Scott, proud alumni of Hugo Buffaloes, Go Buffs.
Hi, I'm Mike Burridge.
Hi, I'm Zach Savage.
We are proud loan officers, First Bank Hugo.
We are also proud supporters of Hugo Athletics. We invite you to come see us at our location at 1501 East Jackson in Hugo, Oklahoma.
Go Buffs. Online at firstbank-ok.com.
First Bank Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Crystal clear, HD radio.
KMMY, Soper.
KITX.
HD2.
Hugo.
Paris. A Payne Media Group station.
My Rock 96.5, home of the Hugo Buffaloes in 21. My name is Will Payne. He's Will Smith, and I'm still getting tripped up on 2020-21.
Yeah, I am too. Yeah, we're struggling here. Have been since we got to Silo and had to scramble to get this stuff on the air. But we do have it on YouTube, which hopefully you are watching on that. And certainly we hope you're listening to us here as Silo right now with a minute 58. Just trying to drain the clock. Three-point shot is up and in. And this one is slipping away from the Lady Buffs in a hurry as they go down 10 to the number two ranked Silo Lady Rebels. You know, the Buffaloes, Lady Buffs right now, they're ranked number 11. They're just on the outside there. And, if you go by the rankings, sometimes you can, sometimes you can't. Mostly you can't, but three-point shot is up, and nothing but string music for Zion Bills. They have a chance to get to the tournament if they play well come February.
I don't think there's any question. This is a pretty good Silo Lady Rebel team that had been struggling over the last couple weeks, but trying to find their way back in against our Lady Buffaloes. And the Lady Buffaloes have been competitive throughout the year.
Yeah, but here's the thing. When you say struggling, you're talking about losing to some really good teams.
Talking about Silo, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't necessarily call that struggling. Just sometimes the ball don't bounce your way. Buffaloes get a steal. They're down by 7. Shot is up and no good. Rebound is controlled by Silo. And right now with 49 seconds left, Silo has the lead. They are up by 7 and the basketball. Harmon's just going to hold it out front until somebody comes and guards, or finally Asia Jordan does. But right now, Will, this one I think is
– it's in the books.
Yeah, as Joanne says, whatever you do with the dogs, you can do that.
Called the dogs, slapped the end gate on it. 23 seconds and counting, 41-34 in favor of Silo. And Silo, what I really am impressed by this team is they've got a little bit of everything. They've got a lot of grit out of the perimeter, but then they have the ability, the size, and the athleticism underneath to go to the bucket. So they can pretty much, coaching-wise, he can do about anything he wants to do, whether slow it down on the outside or go straight to the inside or just go run the basketball down the court. Yeah. I mean, they're not wanting to slow it down.
No question about it. Buffalo's trying to get a shot off here with 10 seconds to go. Jordan Holman's shot off the back of the rim. But the Buffaloes are going to lose this when they're down 41-34 with 3 seconds. But you look at this Silo team, they're going to make some noise in 2A.
No question about that. Very talented, athletic group. They played very, very strong. And you never saw any panic at them in that first half when they were down. And they come back and end up beating the Buffaloes 41-34, the final here tonight for the Lady Buffs.
There you go. The game is over, and the Buffalo boys are coming up next.
You're going to watch it live on Payne Media Group YouTube account tonight. We've shared that across our social media, so thank you very much for being patient with this. Lady Buff action complete, 41-34. Silo the winner here. Hugo Buffalo boys next here on My Rock 96.5.
It's My Rock 96.5, it's the Blade Runner radio show. My Rock 96.5 is the place for your Hugo Buffaloes. You can watch all the activity live, online. If you would like to watch and listen, crank it up in stereo right here at My Rock 96.5.
Little Dixie, Community Action Agency Incorporated, helping people help themselves. The Court-Appointed Special Advocate, or CASA, is a program that recruits and trains volunteers to be advocates for abused and neglected children as they move through the court system. For more information about CASA, call 580-298-2921. 248-298-2921. And for a listing of all programs and services, go to www.littledixie.org.
Grab your lucky stuffed animal.
Come on, Mr. Wiggles. We got to win this game.
Because it's time.
First United, united to serve. There's a bank working hard for you all across the state. People helping to see you through. That's what makes United great. First United, united to serve.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
Mike, you're killing me. I'm ready for a nap.
Oh, no, you forgot to drop off the taxes.
How did you know?
Because they're on the table.
Well, I guess I'll have to run by Burgess & Burgess CPA.
Don't worry. Burgess & Burgess CPA have a website. There you go. Dad, now you're on BurgessCPA.com for all your tax help and bookkeeping needs.
Thanks, son.
And when you stop by Burgess & Burgess CPA, tell them Hayes Payne sent ya.
The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks. The Buffalo Grill has scrumptious appetizers. Soon to be world famous Noah's Ark Burger, barbecue, and for dessert, you gotta try the sugar waffle. The Buffalo Grill, Monday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. Owners Trey and Brenda Chappell are ready to give you a new and unique dining experience like never before. The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks.
The foundation of success for any business is a strong sense of community. At Bank First, our roots run deep in Oklahoma. In fact, we're in more than 50 communities statewide. We're proud to be your next door neighbors and your friends. Whether you have basic checking, cash management, or investment needs, Bank First can provide quality financial products for your business to prosper. Let us be your business partner. You'll find our people make a world of difference. Bank First, loyal to Oklahoma, loyal to you. Member FDIC.
Hey, this is Jeremy Davis, the worship pastor at First Baptist Church of Hugo. I just want to invite you to join us on Sundays at 11 a.m. live in person at 300 East Jackson here in Hugo, on Facebook at facebook.com/FBCHugo, or on 99.5 The Dove FM. You can go to fbchugo.org for more information. We hope to see you this Sunday, and from all of us at First Baptist Church, go Buffs!
Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson JUCO, is pleased to announce the 2020 Model Year End Clearance Event. They have 82 2020s in stock that must go to make room for the 2021 arriving soon. A 2020 Ford Fusion up to $7,000 off. A 2020 Ford F-150 XLT up to $11,000 off. A 2020 Ford Expedition XLT up to $12,000 off. Interest rates at an all-time low, starting at 0% on select models. And they have banks begging to lend money. So don't miss out. Shop Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, Hugo.
First Bank Hugo, this is Wade Scott, proud alumni of Hugo Buffaloes. Go Buffs.
Hi, I'm Mike Burridge.
Hi, I'm Zach Savage.
We are proud loan officers, First Bank Hugo.
We are also proud supporters of Hugo Athletics. We invite you to come see us at our location at 1501 East Jackson in Hugo, Oklahoma.
Go Buffs. Online at firstbank-ok.com.
First Bank Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Make sure you join us for the Blade Runner Radio Show, 5 to 8 a.m. Monday through Friday and 3 to 7 p.m. weekdays here on My Rock 96.5. Play all your favorite songs, and if we miss any, remind us at 623-ALL-ROCK, 623-ALL-ROCK. We'll give you a shout-out. On Fridays, we do Goat Swap Shop. Each day, we kick off the show with Blade Runner Radio Show, things to do for free, and we have the meme of the day and more. My Rock 96.5. Go Buffs!
Yeah, My Rock 96.5 is home of your Hugo Buffaloes in 2021. Will Payne alongside Will Smith, and we are in Silo tonight. Lady Buffs go down to Silo, Rebels 41-34. Hugo Buffs on the court, taking the shoot around. And first half action coming up next here on My Rock 96.5.
Broadcasting in crystal clear HD radio.
It's My Rock 96.5. It's the Blade Runner Radio Show.
Hugo. Paris.
A Payne Media Group station.
It's My Rock 96.5, but it's the Blade Runner radio show. My Rock 96.5 but is the place for your Hugo Buffaloes. You can watch all the activity live online. If you would like to watch and listen, crank it up in stereo right here at My Rock 96.5.
Little Dixie, Community Action Agency Incorporated, helping people help themselves. The Court-Appointed Special Advocate, or CASA, is a program that recruits and trains volunteers to be advocates for abused and neglected children as they move through the court system. For more information about CASA, call 580-298-2921. And for a listing of all programs and services, go to www.littledixie.org.
Grab your lucky stuffed animal.
Come on, Mr. Wiggles. We gotta win this game.
Because it's time.
First United, united to serve. There's a bank working hard for you all across the state. People helping to see you through. That's what makes United great. First United, united to serve.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
Mike, you're killing me. I'm ready for a nap.
Oh, no, you forgot to drop off the taxes.
How did you know?
Because they're on the table.
Well, I guess I'll have to run by Burgess & Burgess CPA.
Don't worry. Burgess & Burgess CPA have a website. There you go. Dad, now you're on BurgessCPA.com for all your tax help and bookkeeping needs.
Thanks, son.
And when you stop by Burgess & Burgess CPA, tell them Hayes Payne sent ya.
The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks. The Buffalo Grill has scrumptious appetizers. Soon to be world famous Noah's Ark Burger, barbecue, and for dessert, you gotta try the sugar waffle. The Buffalo Grill, Monday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. Owners Trey and Brenda Chappell are ready to give you a new and unique dining experience like never before. The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks.
The foundation of success for any business is a strong sense of community. At Bank First, our roots run deep in Oklahoma. In fact, we're in more than 50 communities statewide. We're proud to be your next-door neighbors and your friends. Whether you have basic checking, cash management, or investment needs, Bank First can provide quality financial products for your business to prosper. Let us be your business partner. You'll find our people make a world of difference. Bank First, loyal to Oklahoma, loyal to you. Member FDIC.
Hey, this is Jeremy Davis, the worship pastor at First Baptist Church of Hugo. I just want to invite you to join us on Sundays at 11 a.m. live in person at 300 East Jackson here in Hugo, on Facebook at facebook.com/FBCHugo, or on 99.5 The Dove FM. You can go to fbchugo.org for more information. We hope to see you this Sunday, and from all of us at First Baptist Church, go Buffs!
Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson JUCO, is pleased to announce the 2020 Model Year End Clearance Event. There's 82 2020s in stock that must go to make room for the 2021 arriving soon. A 2020 Ford Fusion up to $7,000 off. A 2020 Ford F-150 XLT up to $11,000 off. A 2020 Ford Expedition XLT up to $12,000 off. Interest rates at an all-time low, starting at 0% on select models. And they have banks begging to lend money. So don't miss out. Shop Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, Hugo.
First Bank Hugo, this is Wade Scott, proud alumni of Hugo Buffaloes. Go Buffs.
Hi, I'm Mike Burridge.
Hi, I'm Zach Savage.
We are proud loan officers, First Bank Hugo.
We are also proud supporters of Hugo Athletics. We invite you to come see us at our location at 1501 East Jackson in Hugo, Oklahoma.
Go Buffs. Online at firstbank-ok.com.
First Bank Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Make sure you join us for the Blade Runner Radio Show, 5 to 8 a.m. Monday through Friday and 3 to 7 p.m. weekdays here on My Rock 96.5. Play all your favorite songs, and if we miss any, remind us at 623-ALL-ROCK, 623-ALL-ROCK. We'll give you a shout-out. On Fridays, we do Goat Swap Shop. Each day, we kick off the show with Blade Runner Radio Show, things to do for free, and we have the meme of the day and more. My Rock 96.5. Go Buffs!
My
Rock 96.5, home of the Hugo Buffaloes in 2021. Will Payne alongside Will Smith. We are high up in the rafters as we're about to bring you Hugo Buffalo basketball. Hugo Buffalo boys undefeated on this season, Will. Whether it's tournament play or just recreational play, home and away, the Buffaloes have that big goose egg on the right side of the board, and that's what you want.
Yeah, they are a perfect 11-0 right now, Will, and they are ranked number 3 in the state behind an old familiar flow, Millwood, who they've lost to numerous times. Even when they beat them, they didn't beat them. And then you got Crossing Christian, number 2, went 1-1 against them last year in the area final. And then, you look at Crossing Christians, they beat they beat Millwood earlier in the season. I'm not sure whether it was still football season or not. But the Buffalo starters being announced right now. And you got Trayvon Brown. You got Grant, Davion Grant in there. You got Chris Akins. You got Dante Shanklin. And last but not least, the gentle giant there, Dawson Bostic.
And then you've got a very, very talented host of let's say contributors that will come off the bench tonight as well for the Buffs.
I don't think there is any question. You're talking about Keon Johnson. You're talking about A.J. Thompson. You're talking about the fast man down there, the quarterback for the Buffaloes. That's going to be Zion.
Yeah, Zion Cook is an amazing athlete. Zion Cook underneath the underneath the bucket or going down the court. I mean, you just go down the list here, and the top five are the top five, but the next five could start anywhere in the state.
No question about it. Here's the funny thing about this ironic thing. In girls' action, it was the Silo girls that were ranked in the top 3, and the Buffaloes are ranked number 11, okay? In this deal, your Buffaloes are ranked in the top 3. The Silo boys are number 11.
Wow. Yeah, so it flip-flops a little bit, right?
Yeah, so no question about it. Coach Shanklin, Coach Akins, and Coach Kilpatrick down there for the Buffaloes trying to get everything in order before the tip-off for Hugo as the Buffaloes come back out onto the court. Good to see the Buffaloes back into action. They are in their all-black uniform. Silo comes out. They are in their white with the red and the blue outlines. We're about to get this thing tipped off. Bostic's going to go to center court. Tip controlled by Silo. Little bounce pass didn't work. Buffaloes get the basketball. Trayvon Brown has it. Gets it up to Davion Grant as right now Silo going to be packed in. They're going to do a little matchup zone.
Has Grant grown maybe 3 inches since the last time we've seen him?
He does look bigger. Maybe he's wearing lifters, Will.
I don't know. It looks a lot taller than the last time we've seen him.
Yeah, he really does. Right now, the Buffalo is going to take a long three. It's going to be off the back of the rim by Trayvon Brown. No good. Got a little impatient there, Will, as they're just going to pack that zone in, try to dare the Buffaloes
to take the 3-point. Oh. And there are 3 or 4 guys that will be willing to do that all day long.
Oh, I'm telling you. Dante Shanklin, Brown, all those guys, really. I don't think any of them are scared. Air ball on the first shot's no good. Dante Shanklin got tangled up with the Silo player, Empson, wasn't able to corral the rebound.
I don't think Dante saw that ball being shot, or if he did, he had a chance to take the easy rebound.
Yeah, I think you're right. So, like you said, trying to get it inside. Silo just working it around right now, opening moments of the basketball game. Nice job knocked away by Dawson Bostic. He goes over the back, though, knocking it away from Wilkerson, number 33. That's going to be Bostic's first team foul.
Still 0-0, 6:46 here in the first, but the Buffaloes looking to try to get out there and use some of that speed.
Yeah, pitching a shutout right now. Both teams playing great defense. As Silo just trying to work it in right now. It's kind of like the four corners deal. It's kind of like the Durant deal, and then we're going to get a travel as Empson tries to penetrate the lane, and when he does, shuffles his feet.
The Buffaloes have had several shots, opportunities here, but just have to learn to show a little patience there, see if they can't get this offense in gear, either get the transition bucket or be patient trying to get the ball back up underneath the center.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. They'll get that offense kick-started on the defense. Once they score, look for them to go full court. as they really packing in this defense right now. Dante Shanklin puts the bank shot up. It's no good. Bostic right there to put it up. But the Buffaloes, they're not going to pressure, Will. They're just going to lay back, pick everybody up at half court. 2-0, the Buffaloes on top.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see if Coach Shanklin decides to change that up a little bit and do a full-court press.
I'm telling you, with the bench that Hugo has, I would run them end-to-end. Dawson Bostic comes down with a missed shot. Silo got a good look there, just a shot off the back of the rim and no good. Buffaloes with the basketball. Davion Grant has it as he's looking for Akins. He's the high post, nothing there. Gets it to Trayvon Brown. And the Buffaloes right now, I don't want to say they struggle with the zone, but they'd much rather go man-to-man. Chris Akins' shot is no good. Buffaloes trying to get a shot off. Nice job saving it there. Akins does, trying to get it to Davion Grant. It's going to go out of bounds off of Silo. Good effort here by both teams in the early going. 5 minutes, 19 seconds to go here in the opening period. Your Buffaloes lead 2-0. Shanklin going to try to get it down low. Can't do it. Gets it up top to Trayvon Brown. Over to Shanklin. Gets it back to Trayvon. Quickly swings it over to Grant. Back up to Brown. He thinks about the NBA three-pointer. Decides to pass that up. Grant's not scared of it, though. Puts it up and puts it in.
Which Buffalo do you want to take the shot? Well, it's whoever has the ball in their hand. And then they're open on the outside. They're going to take that shot every single time. Five-point advantage for the Buffs with 4:52 to go here in the first.
Yes, they are. Another travel call, Will.
I don't know how that happened. A little defense is what that's called by the Buffaloes.
I'm telling you, the Buffaloes up 5-0. Still don't understand why Shanklin's not pressing these guys, but I guess until he has to.
Yeah, wait until the time comes that you need to, right?
Grant with another three-pointer, nothing but string music for Davion. And it's 8-0 quickly as Hugo is up on top. And they're pitching a shutout too, Will.
What makes this team so deadly is the fact that they've got five ball handlers on the court and five shooters on the court.
Yeah, I like that they can play any style too. You know, if you want to slow it down, I'm going to shoot you out of the zone. If you want to press, we'll just kill you if you do that. So
no question. We'll outrun you.
There's really no good answer. You know what I'm saying? Especially if you don't have any defense. The shot is up and it is in. Nice drive there by number 20. That's going to be Ethan Wilkerson. And he's going to go to the line and have a chance to cut it to five with a three-point opportunity.
4:11 to play in the first period, and Silo is just now getting on the board.
Yeah, that's good defense.
Good defense for the Buffs. And it may be a slow, one of those slow rolling type games. We may only see 30, 40 points in this game.
Shanklin goes to the hoop. The runner's no good. Bostic goes up for the rebound. Didn't want to commit the foul, so he backs off. Silo quickly back on the attack as the Buffaloes are going to play some half-court man-to-man. Bostic's going to be guarding Wilkerson.
What do you think about the matchup so far that the Buffaloes are putting on defense?
Yeah, I think, you know, what they're doing on defense my goodness, Chris Akins with a chance on a breakaway, blows a layup. He's going to go to the free throw line and shoot two. But they've been clamped down on defense.
Yeah, defense, right? Coach Shanklin's got him matched up really well, kind of playing a little man-to-man there and just destroying them on that other end of the board.
Yeah, I said talking to him about that Tulsa-Rogers game. They went into halftime 19-10.
Whew.
Buffaloes only scored – anytime you score 10 points and a half
– for the Buffaloes?
Are you in the basketball game? The answer would be no.
No.
But you play clamp-down defense like you do, and that's what he says. He always has a shot.
In the second half, they came back and won that game against Rogers.
Yeah, they did.
I love that.
Won that championship. 10-3, the Buffaloes up on top. They got a little full-court man going, and quickly Silo struggles with it.
Yeah, the freshman couldn't get the ball away.
Finally, they get it across midcourt. Trying to get it down low to Wilkerson, they do, and it's going to go off of Shanklin out of bounds.
Yeah, I believe that's going to be Caleb Wilkerson that we were talking about. He's the freshman. He's the promise. He's the next hope for Silo.
Well, they have one kid, and I don't know who it is, but they have an OU commit on the floor.
Is that Ethan or Kalen?
Breakaway opportunity for Brown, and he jams it home with the left hand.
Wow.
I told Hampton that was going to happen.
It was all Buffaloes, and they need a timeout. We'll take a timeout. Hugo Buffalo basketball is on MyRock 96.5. Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, Hugo, Oklahoma, salutes athletes of all types across the Red River Valley. Congratulations. Your hard work is paying off for you. That is what Ed Wallace Ford has learned over the last few years. A new location, 1700 East Jackson, better to serve you and more value than ever before. Built Ford tough? Come experience it yourself. Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, or online, edwallaceford@hugo.com. My Rock 96.5, home of the Hugo Buffaloes in 2021. Will Payne alongside Will Smith. And the Buffaloes with a commanding lead here, 12-3 with 3:21 to go here in the first.
Yeah, they really are. They came out, they jumped on top, and getting back out to it, they're going to let them get the ball up the court without any opposition. Silo gets it across midcourt.
But when they did give him the full court press, they destroyed him.
I guess they're only going to break that out on special occasions tonight. Long three-point shot is up. No good. Trayvon Brown, the Brown that jammed it home while ago, he gets the rebound, drives, kicks it out to Grant. Three-point shot up and in. Grant has 9 points here in the first period.
NBA three is where that one was from. Yeah. At least 2 foot outside the line.
Yeah, that wasn't even close to the three-point line. Grant falls down, though. They get the shot off. It's still no good. The Buffaloes cannot corral the rebound. Nice block there by Akins. Almost had a breakaway. Silo corrals it. And
they want to reset.
Yeah, they do. Grant really doing a good job pressuring the basketball as wanting to get the five-second call, but he penetrated, so it negated that. But he is all over Proctor, number one. Shot is up, and it is good. Nice shot there by Proctor over Shanklin, and it ends the Hugo run. The Buffaloes still up double digits, 15-5.
2:03 to play here in the first, and the Buffaloes going to just set the offense up here.
Yeah, Trayvon Brown, the point guard, gets it to Akins, the high post. He dribbles, puts a hook shot up. It's no good. A.J. Thompson into the game now. Cannot corral the rebound. Silo comes down with it as they have a chance to cut into the double-digit lead. Up top to the high post there. They get it back over in the corner to Empson. Back down low. A pass to no one that is ran down by Empson. He gets it over in the corner to Wilkerson. Back up top. The shot is up and good. Nice shot there by number 33. That's going to be Kalen Wilkerson. Yeah. As he gets an open look unguarded, and he sinks it. Cuts the lead down to 7.
Yeah, big man from outside there makes a really nice shot. 7-point advantage for your Buffaloes with 1:10 to play in the first.
Well, the thing about it, AJ's got to get out there on him, Will. He can't just let him have an open three. He's a big boy, but he can still shoot. Down low to Akins, puts the shot up and in, and the Buffaloes in the Silo 5-point run and get back up on top by 9, 17-8, with just under a minute to go here in the first quarter as Zan Cook gets set to check in. Defensive specialist for the Buffaloes. Might have been a walk there, Will. What do you think?
I thought that was a 360 with about four steps.
It's kind of like
ballerina moves there.
Wow. All right.
So maybe it didn't count because he was on his tippy toes.
Yeah, 7-point basketball game. Buffalo's going to work it around, look for the last shot. Trayvon Brown with the basketball. Nobody's on him, so he's just going to let the Silo defense rest. Gets it back up top to Dante Shanklin with 17 seconds left.
Which is uncharacteristically like, unlike the Buffaloes, to wait and play for the last shot.
I know it. They generally just try to go get the points and worry about defense later. They get it into Shanklin. They get it to Trayvon Brown. Three-pointer is up, and it is good. The Buffaloes go on top 20-10.
For 100 years, Community Coffee has been dedicated to making expertly roasted and blended coffees, as well as great-tasting hot and iced teas, all for the communities that mean the world to us, which include local businesses like yours. With a growing selection of hot and cold beverages to choose from, there's always something new brewing. So make it a refreshing choice for your business. Make it Community.
Delivered locally by Kaimishi Opportunities. Call 580-326-3000.
7548 today.
The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks. The Buffalo Grill has scrumptious appetizers. Soon to be world famous Noah's Ark burger, barbecue, and for dessert, you gotta try the sugar waffle. The Buffalo Grill, Monday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. Owners Trey and Brenda Chappell are ready to give you a new and unique dining experience like never before. The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks.
My Rock 96.5, home of the Hugo Buffaloes in 2020-2021.
Broadcasting in crystal clear HD radio.
KMMY, Soper.
KITX.
HD.
2. Hugo.
Paris. A Payne Media Group station.
Will Payne alongside Will Smith. Second quarter action underway. 7:56. Buffaloes lead by 10, 20-10 over Silo.
All right, so the Buffaloes have some new players in the game. They got Zan Cook. They got Trey Mack in there along with Keon Johnson. For Hugo. Down low, they still got the big boy Dawson Bostic, so working that around. They get Zan Cook. He's a good high post. His shot is blocked. He corrals the blocked shot, though, gets it back to Davion Grant. Looking down low for Bostic, nothing there. And the Buffalo is going to reset the offense. But this is a great thing about Hugo. Man, they've got so much. They've got so much depth, Will. They can take a little break here on offense. They extend, has another three-pointer. He was feeling it a little too much, Grant was, and then knifes into the paint. He missed a three-pointer there. Trey Mack gets a rebound, tries to pass it into him. He bobbles it, and now the Buffalo's resetting the offense with Grant, though. But you can get a little break at the end of the first quarter, extend it on into the second quarter.
Boy, that pays dividends. Like
yeah, it really does. Because you can get a nice little run going toward halftime, get a little rest, come back out in the third quarter. Refreshed again. So, you know, depth is playing dividends for the Buffaloes. Dawson Bostic with the rebound and dribble it down the court like a point guard, dishing it off to Cook, back to Bostic. His shot is no good into the paint, and Silo is going to come away with the rebound.
Wilkerson for Silo, the Wilkerson, Ethan or Wilkerson on the other side is Caleb.
We got Ethan.
Either one of them, both very good players that down underneath there. They look a little misleading, but, man, they play tough underneath the basket.
Yeah, they do a great job. Shot is up and no good. Hugo controls the rebound. The point guard gets it. Outlet pass to Keon Johnson. He drives into the paint, puts a runner up, and good for the Buffaloes as they go up by 12. Keon Johnson, coast to coast.
When you've got trees like the Wilkerson twins here, right, not twins, obviously, brothers or family members, but when you have them, you can get those quick transition buckets. That's going to make it super easy. You let them set up and play defense, makes it much harder.
No question about it. Outlet pass off the rebound from Bostic. Shot is up and good by Zan Cook. And the Buffaloes right now with many of the second-teamers that open up a 14-point lead.
Absolutely no fear there. As a timeout on the court, we'll take one, too. 24 for your Buffs, 10 for Silo. 5:34 here to go in the first. Second quarter here on MyRock 96.5.
The foundation of success for any business is a strong sense of community. At Bank First, our roots run deep in Oklahoma. In fact, we're in more than 50 communities statewide. We're proud to be your next-door neighbors and your friends. Whether you have basic checking, cash management, or investment needs, Bank First can provide quality financial products for your business to prosper. Let us be your business partner. You'll find our people make a world of difference. Bank First, loyal to Oklahoma, loyal to you. Member FDIC.
My feet are killing me. I'm ready for a nap.
Oh, no, you forgot to drop off the taxes.
How did you know?
Because they're on the table.
Well, I guess I'll have to run by Burgess & Burgess CPA.
Don't worry. Burgess & Burgess CPA have a website. There you go. Dad, now you're on BurgessCPA.com for all your tax help and bookkeeping needs.
Thanks, son.
And when you stop by Burgess & Burgess CPA, tell them Hayes Payne sent you.
My Rock 96.5, welcome back. Second quarter action, 5:14 to play here. 24-12 in favor of your Buffaloes.
Yeah, quick two-point bucket there by Proctor for Silo. Cuts the lead to 12. Trayvon Brown with a three-point shot. It's no good. Silo gets the rebound. Hayes, your son, talked a little too long there, Will. Got a little break late. Got out of the break late. I believe we're going to have a foul on the Buffaloes there. It's probably going to go on Keon Johnson. He made contact going for the rebound. But, hey, you know, that's the thing about your son. He acts a lot like you. And how many times has he been contact traced now? Like 15?
15, but good news is each time he went and got tested negative. So he's enjoying his extended stay at home. Maybe he's not enjoying it.
I don't think he is.
I'm enjoying this, though.
Yeah, it's a great time here. Buffalo's had some numbers there on the steal. Kind of bobbled it at the end, couldn't get a shot off, but they do retain possession. Chris Akins, Trayvon Brown up front. Dante Shanklin over in the corner drives, puts up the runner. It's no good. Silo comes down with the rebound.
I had a chance there at the midcourt line there. He bobbled the ball. Looked like they had a chance to call something, and he was able to get it away quickly.
Thought we might have had a backcourt violation. Wow. Buffaloes just go ferociously after that shot block. It's going to be a two-shot foul. But you still got to like that effort, just patrolling the paint like they do.
They have done a good job tonight. If you come into that the Buffalo paint, you are going to pay for it tonight. That no question. That two Buffaloes kind of shuffled over there and went up with the hack, and they draw the foul.
Yeah, one way or another, you are going to pay for it there. As going to the line for Silo is going to be number three. That's going to be Carter Parker, undoubtedly a Democrat.
How about Coach Jenkins really coaching the guys up as they come on in and off the court?
Yeah, he's really got after Trey Mack there. Because I think they had the block, but Trey Mack got him with the body. Second shot is no good, so no harm on the foul. Keon Johnson gets a rebound. He's across midcourt and over on the right wing quickly as he kicks it off to Brown. Gets it down low to Zan Cook. He had to catch it and go up.
He did a great job of just catching the ball. That was tough.
Yeah, great hands, but he couldn't get the shot up, and the defense had time to react. Blocked the shot. Nice play there by the Silo defense there. Wilkerson doing a good job once again.
And then Zanker's got to go back the other direction and try to guard him.
Yeah, and he's
giving up a foot.
Yeah, he's giving up a foot. But that's the thing about Cook. He plays so tough down low.
3:33 to hear it in a second.
Long three-point shot off the mark, no good. Johnson quickly to Shanklin. Is he going to jam it? No, he does a little reverse layup, and it is no good. Silo comes away with the rebound.
Boy, they had some numbers, Will.
Yeah, they really did. Just could not get it to go. Silo there with a little pump fake. Loses control of the basketball. Goes out of bounds off of Hugo.
So 3:10 to go in the second. It's 24-12 in favor of Hugo. Hugo's been cruising through most part of the game so far, Will, and that's given a lot of opportunities for the Buffaloes to get on the court.
Yeah, they really has. Right now, Silo just kind of struggling right now. We're 3 minutes away from half. Silo has 12 points. So you just can't say enough about the defense of Hugo up to this point.
Just wearing them down.
Yeah, they really are. And doing it, for the most part, second quarter with the second teamers.
You're right about that, giving a lot of rest to the starters. We'll see what they can do.
That's the thing I like about Hugo's players. We say second teamers, but they're not. They're just part of the rotation. They just don't start the basketball game. Silo's shot is up, no good. And the Buffalo's playing tough down low. A lot of contact there, no foul. They're kind of letting them play. Trayvon Brown into the paint. Gets it to Keon Johnson. He don't want to see his shot blocked. Nice job. Pass down to A.J.
Woo!
He puts it up Woo! And in. Nice shot. Little moonshot by A.J.
Showing the hands for A.J. How about that? And the Buffaloes take a 26-12 lead with 2:05 to play here in the second.
Well, you just think about A.J. a little bit. Think about what he has to practice against every day.
Every day.
My goodness.
Thompson doing a great job in showing those soft hands.
Yeah, he really is. Pass is going to go out of bounds. They're going to say it's off Trayvon Brown. So Silo is going to keep control of the basketball. Under 2 minutes to go here. 26-12. Hugo on top. Get a little screen there for Wilkerson. And then just a little give and go with number 20. That's Ethan Wilkerson. He can't get anything going. And Trayvon Brown with the steal. Looking to put the runner up. He's going to be fouled and go to the line to shoot a couple of free throws.
Yeah, that's going to be Proctor's foul there. I wish I could tell you. That surely can't be right. they haven't put it up there yet. Yeah, that's going to be his second foul.
Yeah, it's going to be his second. second foul, and it's going to be their second team foul as Trayvon Brown goes to the line. Another great Buffalo guard wearing his All-State jacket in the gym tonight. That's going to be G. Lennox.
Hey, good to see Lennox back.
Yeah, it really is.
I saw King earlier, got Lennox here. You know, that's what the brotherhood of the Buffalo basketball team is amazing. Year after year when you see them come back and watch the next line of Buffaloes compete for that state championship.
No question about it. And talking about Lennox, one of my favorite players of all time. That kid was just an unbelievable player, as Trayvon Brown is as well. Gets a steal, gets a basket. A little full court action here with a minute and a half.
Pick.
Another steal by Grant. Can't get it to go. Brown's right there for the putback. He had an easy bucket and couldn't get it. And then we're going to have a foul on the Buffaloes. 29-12, the Buffaloes, after that sequence of events, up on top. Coach Shanklin out on the court, very unhappy with Trayvon for missing that shot.
You had a couple of amazing shots there, because Johnson picked Wilkerson's pocket. The ball was going to Wilkerson, and he was just standing there before the bucket even went in. Didn't have time to react.
Yeah, we got a travel there as Kyler Proctor. He just trying to split the trap there, and he tried to do it like a fullback instead of a basketball player. And
Coach Shanklin turning up the pressure here.
He really has. He wants to finish the half strong, leaving no doubt going into halftime what's going to happen. Trayvon Brown with the basketball, gets it to Grant. He thinks about a three, now inside to Akins, has to get out of the lane. Shanklin, three-point shot's no good. I don't think Shanklin's got on the board tonight, has he?
No, he has not able to make a bucket, but he hadn't had very good looks either.
No, but the looks he's had, he hadn't been able to knock it through. Wilkerson with another bucket, 29-14, just under a minute to go. The Buffaloes up by 15. Coach Shanklin clapping, telling Trayvon Brown to get the offense going. Gets it over to Grant.
Play for the last shot.
Now they're going to play. Looks kind of like they are, unless they can get a good shot. They get it into Akins. The high post over to Brown. He drives into the paint, and it's going to be knocked away. It's going to be Hugo basketball with 39 seconds to go. Substitutions coming in. Dawson Bostic is going to come in for Akins.
Our good friend Bobby Hamill's here tonight, right?
Right.
And you would think, he's had a Hall of Fame career for taking photos for the Buffaloes, right?
No question.
We need to get him some black and gold flannel.
You know, we really do. What did we do there? Is that a five-second call?
It looked like we got out of bounds, what Brett is going to go back to Silo. So if I'm 5 seconds, I'll call on them.
No, I mean us getting it in.
Oh, absolutely. Well, but did we have possession?
Yeah, we had possession.
And we couldn't get the ball in?
We either couldn't get it in or he stepped on the line. I think he stepped
up on the line.
Yep.
Right, so give me the Bobby Hamill update.
Yeah, Bobby needs to get off those Rebel Red colors. 30 seconds to go, 15-point lead for the Buffaloes. Silo trying to knock it down here with 26 seconds. Shot is up, and it is good. Leaves the Buffaloes a little time, though. The lead is down to 13. Davion Grant has the basketball. Across midcourt, gets it to Chris Akins. Over in the corner to Shanklin, looking down low for Brown. There's 12 seconds to go as Grant has the basketball. Trayvon Brown with the three-pointer is no good, and we're going to have a foul. I believe that's going to go against A.J. Thompson. As Silo is going to get the basketball back with 2 seconds, they're going to have a chance for a one-and-one, Will, and an opportunity to cut it down to 11.
Buffalo's kind of giving away some points here late in the second. 201, 29-16, Buffalo's lead, but giving Silo some bonus points before the end of the half.
Yeah, it was 29-12. But the good part about it, it gets Shanklin an opportunity to go into the locker room and just really yell at some people. you know what I'm saying? Chris Akins' three-quarter shot is
almost
no good. Hits the front of the rim and goes off. But we'll go to the halftime. The Buffaloes only up now by 13, 29-16.
Broadcasting in crystal clear HD radio.
KMMY. Soper.
KITX.
HD2.
Hugo.
Paris.
A Payne Media Group station.
It's My Rock 96.5, but it's the Blade Runner radio show. My Rock 96.5 is the place for your Hugo Buffaloes. You can watch all the activity live online. If you would like to watch and listen, crank it up in stereo right here at My Rock 96.5.
Little Dixie, Community Action Agency Incorporated, helping people help themselves. The Court-Appointed Special Advocate, or CASA, is a program that recruits and trains volunteers to be advocates for abused and neglected children as they move through the court system. For more information about CASA, call 580-298-2921. And for a listing of all programs and services, go to www.littledixie.org.
Grab your lucky stuffed animal.
Come on, Mr. Wiggles. We got to win this game.
Because it's time.
First United, united to serve. There's a bank working hard for you all across the state. People helping to see you through. That's what makes United great. First United, united to serve.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
Mike, you're killing me. I'm ready for a nap.
Oh, no, you forgot to drop off the taxes.
How did you know?
Because they're on the table.
Well, I guess I'll have to run by Burgess & Burgess CPA.
Don't worry. Burgess & Burgess CPA have a website. There you go. Dad, now you're on BurgessCPA.com for all your tax help and bookkeeping needs.
Thanks, son.
And when you stop by Burgess & Burgess CPA, tell them Hayes Payne sent ya.
The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks. The Buffalo Grill has scrumptious appetizers. Soon to be world famous Noah's Ark Burger, barbecue, and for dessert, you gotta try the sugar waffle. The Buffalo Grill, Monday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. Owners Trey and Brenda Chappell are ready to give you a new and unique dining experience like never before. The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks.
The foundation of success for any business is a strong sense of community. At Bank First, our roots run deep in Oklahoma. In fact, we're in more than 50 communities statewide. We're proud to be your next door neighbors and your friends. Whether you have basic checking, cash management, or investment needs, Bank First can provide quality financial products for your business to prosper. Let us be your business partner. You'll find our people make a world of difference. Bank First, loyal to Oklahoma, loyal to you. Member FDIC.
Hey, this is Jeremy Davis, the worship pastor at First Baptist Church of Hugo. I just want to invite you to join us on Sundays at 11 a.m. live in person at 300 East Jackson here in Hugo, on Facebook at facebook.com/FBCHugo, or on 99.5 The Dove FM. You can go to fbchugo.org for more information. We hope to see you this Sunday, and from all of us at First Baptist Church, go Buffs!
Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson JUCO, is pleased to announce the 2020 Model Year End Clearance Event. There's 82 2020s in stock that must go to make room for the 2021 arriving soon. A 2020 Ford Fusion up to $7,000 off. A 2020 Ford F-150 XLT up to $11,000 off. A 2020 Ford Expedition XLT up to $12,000 off. Interest rates at an all-time low, starting at 0% on select models. And they have banks begging to lend money. So don't miss out. Shop Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, Hugo.
First Bank Hugo, this is Wade Scott, proud alumni of Hugo Buffaloes. Go Buffs.
Hi, I'm Mike Burridge.
Hi, I'm Zach Savage.
We are proud loan officers, First Bank Hugo.
We are also proud supporters of Hugo Athletics. We invite you to come see us at our location at 1501 East Jackson in Hugo, Oklahoma.
Go Buffs. Online at firstbank-ok.com.
First Bank, equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Make sure you join us for the Blade Runner Radio Show, 5 to 8 a.m. Monday through Friday and 3 to 7 p.m. weekdays here on My Rock 96.5. Play all your favorite songs, and if we miss any, remind us at 623-ALL-ROCK, 623-ALL-ROCK. We'll give you a shout-out. On Fridays, we do Goat Swap Shop. Each day, we kick off the show with Blade Runner Radio Show, things to do for free, and we have the meme of the day and more. My Rock 96.5. Go Buffs!
My Rock 96.5, home of the Hugo Buffaloes in 2021. Will Payne alongside Will Smith. We're at the half. It's your Buffaloes 29. It's the Silo Rebels 16.
It's My Rock 96.5, but it's the Blade Runner Radio Show. My Rock 96.5 is the place for your Hugo Buffaloes. You can watch all the activity live online. If you would like to watch and listen, crank it up in stereo right here at My Rock 96.5.
Little Dixie, Community Action Agency Incorporated, helping people help themselves. The Court-Appointed Special Advocate, or CASA, is a program that recruits and trains volunteers to be advocates for abused and neglected children as they move through the court system. For more information about CASA, call 580-298-2921. And for a listing of all programs and services, go to www.littledixie.org.
Grab your lucky stuffed animal.
Come on, Mr. Wiggles. We gotta win this game.
Because it's time.
First United, united to serve. There's a bank working hard for you all across the state. People helping to see you through. That's what makes United great. First United, united to serve.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
My, you're killing me. I'm ready for a nap.
Oh, no, you forgot to drop off the taxes.
How did you know?
Because they're on the table.
Well, I guess I'll have to run by Burgess & Burgess CPA.
Don't worry. Burgess & Burgess CPA have a website. There you go. Dad, now you're on BurgessCPA.com for all your tax help and bookkeeping needs.
Thanks, son.
And when you stop by Burgess & Burgess CPA, tell them Hayes Payne sent ya.
The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks. The Buffalo Grill has scrumptious appetizers. Soon to be world famous Noah's Ark Burger, barbecue, and for dessert, you gotta try the sugar waffle. The Buffalo Grill, Monday through Saturday, 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. Owners Trey and Brenda Chappell are ready to give you a new and unique dining experience like never before. The Buffalo Grill in Hugo, Oklahoma, on Jackson Street east of the railroad tracks.
The foundation of success for any business is a strong sense of community. At Bank First, our roots run deep in Oklahoma. In fact, we're in more than 50 communities statewide. We're proud to be your next door neighbors and your friends. Whether you have basic checking, cash management, or investment needs, Bank First can provide quality financial products for your business to prosper. Let us be your business partner. You'll find our people make a world of difference. Bank First, loyal to Oklahoma, loyal to you. Member FDIC.
Hey, this is Jeremy Davis, the worship pastor at First Baptist Church of Hugo. I just want to invite you to join us on Sundays at 11 a.m. live in person at 300 East Jackson here in Hugo, on Facebook at facebook.com/FBCHugo, or on 99.5 The Dove FM. You can go to fbchugo.org for more information. We hope to see you this Sunday, and from all of us at First Baptist Church, go Buffs.
Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson JUCO, is pleased to announce the 2020 Model Year End Clearance Event. They have 82 2020s in stock that must go to make room for the 2021 arriving soon. A 2020 Ford Fusion up to $7,000 off. A 2020 Ford F-150 XLT up to $11,000 off. A 2020 Ford Expedition XLT up to $12,000 off. Interest rates at an all-time low, starting at 0% on select models. And they have banks begging to lend money. So don't miss out. Shop Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, Hugo.
First Bank Hugo, this is Wade Scott, proud alumni of Hugo Buffaloes. Go Buffs.
Hi, I'm Mike Burridge.
Hi, I'm Zach Savage.
We are proud loan officers, First Bank Hugo.
We are also proud supporters of Hugo Athletics. We invite you to come see us at our location at 1501 East Jackson in Hugo, Oklahoma.
Go Buffs. Online at firstbank-ok.com.
First Bank, equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Make sure you join us for the Blade Runner Radio Show, 5 to 8 a.m. Monday through Friday and 3 to 7 p.m. weekdays here on My Rock 96.5. Play all your favorite songs, and if we miss any, remind us at 623-ALL-ROCK, 623-ALL-ROCK. We'll give you a shout-out. On Fridays, we do Goat Swap Shop each day. We kick off the show with Blade Runner Radio Show, things to do for free, and we have the meme of the day and more. My Rock 96.5. Go Buffs!
Back to second half action here in Silo. Will Payne, Will Smith. 7:58 to play in the third underway. Buffalo's leading 29-16. Yeah, having a great time here, Will. The Buffaloes up on top by 13. We've seen some spectacular basketball. They just call a foul on Dawson Bostic. He can't believe it. It's going to be a two-shot foul, though, but they're going to send number 20. That's going to be Ethan Wilkerson to the line. And going to shoot a couple of free throws.
And Bostic has been on the bench for most of the second period because Coach Shankland was giving him a chance to rest up, getting the fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth man in the ball game tonight.
Yeah, they call it on Bostic. Well, they got Shankland's name up there, or his number up there, his first foul. But I believe that foul went to Bostic. But nevertheless, first free throw is no good. Wilkerson going to shoot, and that's Ethan. Second free throw, it is good. So the lead is down to 12 as Trayvon Brown brings it up for Hugo. Hugo's going to set up the offense with Shanklin. They're going to have Bostic down low. Chris Akins will be the high post. Trayvon Brown flashed open down low, but Grant did not see him. They get it to Akins. Just a little lob in there to Bostic. He puts it up and in, and that's like taking candy from a baby.
Yeah, Akins had a really nice spot underneath, and he saw that there was nothing but two defenders in his way. Bostic right behind him. All he did just kind of lift it up over there, and Bostic skies high to get the ball and makes a nice little layup there to extend the lead 31-17.
You know, I kind of feel sorry for these Silo boys, Will. Not because of the score, but because a lot of these fans have cleared out.
They left at halftime and hadn't come back in yet.
Bostic trying to get the layup to go up and in. Can't do it. It's going to go out of bounds off of Silo. He was in some traffic. Had to put it up quickly. Didn't really have the rhythm going into the basket. Couldn't get it up and in. So Shanklin's going to take it out. The Buffalo's going to stack it up. Shanklin looking for an easy bucket down low. Throws it away. Breakaway opportunity for Silo, and it's going to be blocked, and a great job by Trayvon Brown blocking the shot. He's going to be called for the foul, though.
And Charlie Gardner was the shooter for Silo, who grabbed the pass and took it down. And Coach Croce joined us here in Silo. It's always good to see the football coach coming over and supporting the basketball program as well because, you know, nine times out of ten, Coach Shankland's at the football game supporting the football players.
No question about it. And saw Coach Gross during the girls' game. Coach Debo here, too, as well. So good representation from the Hugo football staff as the first free throw is up and good by Silo. That's going to be Gardner waiting on his second shot. It's going to be no good. Chris Akins comes down with the rebound, gets it to Trayvon Brown. The Buffaloes on top, 31-18.
Defensive boards have been big for the Buffaloes tonight.
Yeah, they really have. Bostic gets his shot blocked. Buffaloes cannot get that offensive board, though. It's going to go over to Silo as Bostic got to go up a little stronger, Will.
He had a chance to get the ball on the rebound there, and Silo was able to just out-muscle him.
Yeah, these kids down low for Silo, they're tall. I mean, they can play down low. They do a good job with their low post. Long three-point shot is up, and it is good. Shot is good by Kalen Wilkerson.
The big man's got a nice touch from three-point. That's his second three-pointer of the night.
Yeah, it really does. Knocks the lead down to 10. And I don't know if the scorekeeper knows or not, but she just put it up as two.
It was a three.
There she got it up. But quickly, Akins gets a two-pointer for the Buffaloes. The lead gets knocked back up to 12, 33-21. Hugo on top. Just getting started here in the third quarter. Thought that might have been a backcourt violation. No call as Silo just kind of working it around. Wilkerson sets a screen, and then they try to lob it in. Chris Akins not having any of that as he intercepts the pass, gets it out to Grant, and the Buffaloes are off and running down to Trayvon Brown, his three-pointer off the back of the rim, no good. Wilkerson pulls down the rebound for Silo, and they're going back the other way. Gets it to his brother, Ethan. Down low, the shot is up, and it is no good. Grant trying to come up with the rebound. He can't get the rebound, but he gets the steal. Outlet pass to Trayvon Brown. The Buffaloes do have some numbers. Three-pointer by Chris Akins. In and out, no good. Brown trying to get the tip in. Can't get it to go. And the Buffaloes right now are really lacking some intensity there on that offensive end.
Just kind of throwing it up, trying to see if it falls, and then trying to do, you know, just go back and try to get the rebound and toss it back up there. Got to settle down just a little bit. Wait for the shot. Take it. Get it down underneath.
A 12-point game here. How about Grant on that last possession there? Me and you would have been on our face on the floor. He was able to tiptoe and keep his, keep his balance there and get the ball down the court.
He's a phenomenal athlete. You know, we talked about this a couple of times. He'd be a great running back, too. He's got great feet. Silo keeping the basketball. The shot is up, and it is good. Nice touch there by Ethan Wilkerson, and the lead is down to 10 for the Buffaloes. 33-23, your Buffaloes up on top. Bostic is wanting that lob. He gets the bounce pass instead, has it blocked, and then loses the basketball. Coach Jenklin not going to be happy at all with Dawson.
Yeah, the ball just goes on the court, and Empson picks it right up.
Three-pointer is up, and it is good. Nice three-point shot there by Kalen Wilkerson. Gets the lead down to 7, 33-26. Still no pressure from the Buffaloes on defense. Akins, he loses the basketball, picks it back up, puts the hook shot up. It's no good. Gets the rebound. Throws it away. The Silo comes up with it. I think Akins a little bit upset. There's a lot of contact down there and no foul call.
And that looks like they're going to let him play tonight.
Another three-point shot is an air ball this time. The Buffaloes come away with the rebound, and they're going to have to get it together on offense. Maybe a little pressure on defense.
I think what we're seeing on Bostic is they're pushing him way underneath the bucket, and so he can't actually get outside of the bucket to go up and get a rebound. He's underneath by the backboard.
He really is. The Buffaloes right now trying to execute that press. Silo able to break it this time. The shot is up, and it is good. Three-pointer is good by Wilkerson. They're knocking them down right now, Will. It's a six-point basketball game. Buffalo's led by as many as 17 in the second quarter.
It'll be very interesting to see how Coach Shanklin, how he's going to let him play. Or
that's what they do. They get it down low to Bostic. He gets good position, puts it up and in. The Buffaloes quickly get two of those points back. No, they're going to do a little full-court press.
Make them earn this.
They knock it away. They get the steal. Shanklin. Ball goes out of bounds. Nice knockaway there by Wilkerson.
Yeah, Wilkerson and Empson. Now, Empson, is, you got the big man Wilkerson. He gets you up top, and then Empson comes down and steals it at a wave at your knees.
Hey, you're right about that. Substitution's coming in for Silo. Also for Hugo, A.J. Thompson's coming in along with Keon Johnson.
We saw Thompson have some success in that second quarter.
Yeah, Thompson flashes down low. They get it out to Keon Johnson. Back up top to Trayvon. Over to Shanklin. A.J. flashes out at the three-point line. He needs to be under there with Bostic.
It'll be interesting. It looks like they're going to go with a little zone for defense.
Yeah, nobody to pass it to. They get it to Shanklin from the free throw line. His shot off the back of the rim, no good. Shanklin just don't have it tonight.
He has missed several wide open shots here. And from the free throw line, he's got to hit those.
Yeah, he really does. That's a wide open look. And then it's going to be no easy shot there as Trayvon Brown and Shanklin just maul the shooter. Well-deserved foul.
We'll see who they decide to call it on. It was just a give and go on that right side. Silo trying to give it and then go, and off they go. And oh, look. I think they're going to say that's Shanklin's second foul.
Yeah, so they did give him the foul that first time.
Brown's like, hey, I got a sixth foul. Hey, I got a freebie. Shanklin's like, how did I get that? How did I end up with two?
Yeah, because he was the one that absolutely hammered the shooter.
And now it's time to sit down. Shanklin's going to sit down.
Hey, you got two fouls. You're late in the third.
Trey Mack's going to get an opportunity to come back in the game.
All right, so you got Trey Mack into the basketball game. Free throws, no good. Second free throws, no good.
I was going to say, man, you're telepathic. You're calling this ahead of time. That's pretty impressive.
All right, the Buffaloes have the basketball and an 8-point lead, chance to get it back up to double digits. I don't know what it is mentally, but when you have a double-digit lead, it just seems way more comfortable than, you know, whether it's
single
9,
digits,
8,
yeah.
5, whatever, you know. So Trayvon Brown's going to shoot the three and drains a three, pumps up the score to 40 for your Buffaloes, 29 for Silo, and the Buffaloes are going to do a little bit of that pressure. I know Silo don't like that. Ball is up for grabs. Hey, how do you not call a foul there? Keon
over the
Johnson,
top.
I mean, a lot of contact there and absolutely no foul. Three-pointer is up and good by Proctor, number one. But that is There's no excuse for not calling that foul.
And that contact will not go unanswered.
No, it won't. They're trying to look down low for A.J. They get it to Trayvon Brown.
And the best play tonight for the Buffaloes is either the lob into Bostic or take the three-point from the outside if you're Brown.
Yeah, and Trayvon Brown back-to-back threes knocks it up to an 11-point lead, 43-32. They get it back to Proctor. He drives into the paint. Might have skidded there. Long three-point shot in and out, no good. Trey Mack can't control the rebound. A.J. can't get the rebound. They kick it over in the corner, and then we're going to have a whistle on the play.
Not sure what they're going to call there, but nice move there by Silo. He fakes the shot, goes underneath, Buffalo's bite, and then the whistle blows.
Yeah, I think that's going to go against Bostic. That's going to be his third. As Zan Cook's going to come in. Probably going to get Bostic out of there. Zan
Probably.
Cook, you know, he gives a foot, but, man, he's every bit the defensive player that Bostic is.
Well, and he plays
kind.
He plays down low and has a good center of gravity.
Rebound goes to the Buffaloes. Keon Johnson gets it, pulls it back out, and the Buffaloes, with 7 seconds, have the basketball. Brown looking for somebody, and no look pass to Zan Cook to A.J. The thing about it was the extra pass to A.J. just wasn't ready for it, didn't get it off. Anyway, the Buffaloes going to the fourth quarter. They're up 43-32.
Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, Hugo, Oklahoma, salutes athletes of all types across the Red River Valley. Congratulations. Your hard work is paying off for you. That is what Ed Wallace Ford has learned over the last few years. A new location, 1700 East Jackson, better to serve you and more value than ever before. Built Ford tough? Come experience it yourself. Ed Wallace Ford, 1700 East Jackson, or online, edwallaceford@hugo.com.
First United, united to serve. There's a bank working hard for you all across the state. People helping to see you through. That's what makes United great. First United, united to serve. United, united to serve.
Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
96.5, home of the Hugo Buffs in 2020. Will Payne alongside Will Smith. And got to say a special thank you and a big salute to one of our fine people that make this broadcast possible. The fine folks from First United Bank, Les. I want to say special thank you to Les. And, of course, his big boss, John Worthy.
Yeah, how about that, Les Shoemaker? Probably ought to be Citizen of the Year, right?
I don't think there's any question. There's a chamber banquet coming up.
He's probably in charge of that.
He probably needs to be Citizen of the Year, and we thank his boss, John Worthy, for making it possible for Les to be so hospitable to the community.
Yes, he has been a great addition to the community, and we enjoy having Les in a variety of activities here in Hugo. Turnaround jumper by Zan Cook is no good off the mark. Silo gets the rebound.
Ooh, twice.
We're going to have a whistle on the play.
Sorry, I got excited.
What happened on that play, Will?
Well, Silo, you know, Wilkerson had the ball, and the Buffaloes jumped right in front of him. And he was in a deer in a headlight look, and he didn't know what to do with his feet. He moved, and they didn't call it, and then he moved again, they called it.
He wanted to make sure they got it. He wanted to be done with it. Trayvon Brown, another three for the Buffaloes.
He is so hot right now. On fire for the Buffaloes from the three-point range.
Yeah, has a lead back up to 14. And I'm telling you, that kid is a gamer. Buffaloes get another steal. Nice no-look pass to Zan Cook. He misses it. Keon Johnson gets a rebound. Back up top to Trey Mack. Trey Mack gets it down low to Keon. Knocked away from him. They need to get it to Trayvon Brown. Let him
absolutely
shoot. Just shoot it from anywhere, Trayvon.
I tell you, this Silo team is going to give a lot of teams a lot of fit. They're good up front, and they're really good in the back, and the new big man can step out there and shoot threes.
I completely agree with you. They're a very good basketball team. One of the better teams we've seen this year.
And the Buffalo is just able to live by the three-pointer and get it down underneath.
Get it down low to A.J. Thompson, his fourth point of the basketball game. And it is a – 48-32 lead for Hugo. Oh, he traveled again and they didn't call it. Did you see the foot drag?
And now we're going to see a timeout. So we'll take a timeout. Buffalo's 48, Rebels from Silo 32, 6:38 to play. This is Hugo Buffalo basketball on MyRock 96.5.
Little Dixie, Community Action Agency Incorporated, helping people help themselves. The Court-Appointed Special Advocate, or CASA, is a program that recruits and trains volunteers to be advocates for abused and neglected children as they move through the court system. For more information about CASA, call 580-298-2921. And for a listing of all programs and services, go to www.littledixie.org.
First Bank Hugo, this is Wade Scott, proud alumni of Hugo Buffaloes. Go Buffs.
Hi, I'm Mike Burridge.
Hi, I'm Zach Savage.
We are proud loan officers, First Bank Hugo.
We are also proud supporters of Hugo Athletics. We invite you to come see us at our location at 1501 East Jackson in Hugo, Oklahoma.
Go Buffs. Online at firstbank-ok.com.
First Bank Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Rock 96.5 open to Hugo Buffaloes in 2021. 6:38 to play. It's your Buffs 48. The Silo Rebels 32. I just realized it's like the Ole Miss Rebels here. The red, the blue, and the old man with the cane and the long mustache, huh?
Oh, yeah. It's old. How do you pronounce that?
Miss?
There you go. Old
Miss.
Strong on the M.
Hotty totty time.
Buffalo's knocking away.
How's that not over and back?
Backcourt violation. There's no call.
Wow.
I mean, you can clearly see it on the video. The shot goes up and it goes in. And there's no way they should have maintained possession.
Some home cooking there.
My goodness.
Home cooking.
That was absolutely beautiful.
He didn't see it. But, yeah, no question, he took a step into the backcourt. And then they're able to turn it the other direction and go to the bucket. Now at the free throw line.
Yeah, and not only it goes to a three-point play, which they convert, but it's also a foul against the Buffaloes.
That's going to be the second foul on the Buffaloes, and that'll be Thompson picking up two.
48-35, the Buffaloes on top by 13. Trayvon Brown with the basketball, throws a bad pass, and it's going to go off of Hugo. They're going to say it went off of Davion Grant. But Trayvon should never throw that pass cross court like that.
Yeah, Cordell was coming over for Silo to try to make a play on it. And he did so well, he's going to take a seat on the bench, and Gardner's going to come back in.
You think he might be related to Byron?
Cordell?
Cordell.
He might be.
Buffaloes knock it away, keep possession of it. Trayvon Brown. And then we're going to have a timeout as Silo maintains possession of it. They get Trayvon lost control of the basketball. Silo gets it back, calls a quick timeout.
We'll keep it right here. This is Hugo Buffalo basketball on MyRock 96.5. And that's what you do if you're on the ground. You call the timeout. They gave it to him. Coach Shanklin kind of coaching up over there because he wasn't exactly thrilled with that call. And he's seen a couple of calls go the other direction, or the lack of calls on the court. And he didn't feel like he's getting the benefit of that. Same, you know, both directions.
I don't think he's got a single call this second half. I mean, I don't really remember any in the first half either.
I think you're right. But the Buffaloes do lead 48-35, brought to you by Ed Wallace Ford. First United Bank, thanks for watching tonight. Appreciate you, John Worthy. Little Dixie Community Action Agency, First Bank is with us. Appreciate you very much. Our friends over at Burgess & Burgess CPA, Kimashi Opportunities, and the Buffalo Grill. Will, back to fourth quarter action. Buffaloes lead 48-35 over Silo. A very good Silo team nonetheless. They may be underclass, but at the top of their class as well.
Yeah, they are ranked number 11 in their classification. And, you know, you look at them and what goes on in 2A, which 2A is a very good class too. Mm-hmm. But with the talent that they have with the big guys, they have an opportunity. They've got to improve the guard play a little bit, obviously. But if they ever get it across midcourt and get it to their big guys, you know, who knows? Nice job on the steal by the Buffaloes. A.J. Thompson comes up with the loose ball, gets it to Chris Akins.
You see him pick that fumble up?
I did, and that's kind of what it was. Chris Akins with the shot up and in. The Buffaloes hit the half-century mark, 50-35, 15-point lead. Double dribble there, no call. A.J. Thompson steps in front, gets the charge. Might have been a little make good there.
I think it was. But we'll take it. We deserved one or two. But, you know, he was able to shift over. I don't know if he was stopped or not, but I know his tiptoes were on the ground. And
I think it hurt A.J. He's got to go sit down.
No good deed goes unpunished.
Coach Shankle wanted to bring him over and just pat him on the back.
I want to talk to you about that, son. I mean, let's talk about that, because next time that probably not going to go your way.
Yeah. We had one coming there, AJ.
You just burnt it. But the Buffaloes lead 50-35, 5:20 to play here in the fourth.
Shanklin with the basketball, gets it to Grant. How about Grant? I mean, when the Buffaloes needed him the most to get the game started, it was just three after three after three.
And then Brown comes up and three after three, and then Shanklin has been cold from the line.
Yeah. So they get it back to Trayvon Brown, over to Grant. Grant to Brown, who finally gets a look at it and gets it in. I mean, that kid is unreal right now. And when he gets hot, he can't miss.
We've had a few point guards that can shoot the ball like that. It's good to see that back at Hugo.
Yeah, I think we had that Nick Brown kid,
he
right?
He was just lights out, ice in the veins.
Then we got cousin Trayvon.
Yeah, Trayvon. Woo, he can shoot.
Shot is up. Off the rim. No good. Wilkerson comes up with the basketball.
I'll tell you what, both Wilkerson players for Silo are the real deal. Very stout. And not afraid to go up and get that basketball.
No, they played outstanding. Number 20, number 33. Shot is up and no good by Ethan Wilkerson. As Chris Akins, he shows his point guard abilities.
That's amazing. The big man, you know, able to dribble like that.
Trying to get it to Bostic. It's going to be knocked away. It's going to be blocked out of bounds. They actually jerk Trayvon Brown's jersey. When he's trying to go for the loose ball, there's no call there.
And there was no call. I might have been a hack underneath the basket against Bostic.
Wow. 53-35. Hugo on top. Silo with the basketball. Hugo really pressuring right now. The ball is loose. Trayvon Brown has it. I believe they're going to be a jump ball.
Yeah.
Coach Shanklin just yelling at everybody right now. He's not happy.
And I'm proud of him. He's got his mask on. You know, he's doing everything he's supposed to do right.
Yeah, he is.
And he's like, going, what's going on, guys? Why? What's this all about?
And you know, that sound's probably coming out like they can't really understand them. You know, like how remember we tried to broadcast in a mask. You just couldn't do it.
Yeah, we tried to do that at the Apollo football game, and maybe it was just a muzzle mess.
Shot is up. No good. Grant tried to get the rebound. Couldn't get it done.
He skied high, and he stayed on his feet.
He did. Shot is up and good. Nice shot there by Proctor. That's a three. Three and a half. It's 53-38. You know, we talked about this before the game. This is kind of about what we thought it'd be, you know?
No, it wasn't. It was exactly what Will thought it was being beat. Will Smith, that is.
Shot is up and good by Trayvon Brown.
Will Payne thought that, you know, the Buffaloes could pull away and win by 30. But somebody forgot to tell me there was two Wilkerson. I thought there was just one.
Just one. Yeah, there's two 6'6 guys.
Yeah.
Hampton told me. I got the scouting report.
You got two of them. I thought there was just one.
No, they got two. And neither one of those guys are the guy that's going to OU. And the guy that's going to OU is not going to play basketball. He's going to play baseball.
Oh, okay. He's a good baseball player.
Yeah. Yeah, there's some good baseball player running around out there, but Hampton didn't give me his
another
name.
Another walk.
They didn't call that. No look pass to Trayvon, and he throws it away.
No, he threw it to Proctor.
Gets it back. Misses the dunk. Gets it back. Puts it up and puts it in. Looks over to Coach Shanklin to make sure he's not about to get pulled.
I'm sorry. If you're going to go for it, you better hit it.
Shanklin, he don't like those missed dunks. He likes the layups. He likes the finger rolls.
It's the high percentage.
Shot is up. No good. Ball is loose. Wilkerson comes down with it. Shanklin still yelling. Shot is almost an air ball. It nicks the front of the rim. Wilkerson gets it, puts it up and in. Great job there by Kalen Wilkerson staying with it as we have a timeout on the court.
We'll take a timeout as well. Buffaloes lead 57-40 with 2:27 to play here on MyRock 96.5.
The foundation of success for any business is a strong sense of community. At Bank First, our roots run deep in Oklahoma.
In fact, we're in more than 50 communities statewide. We're proud to be your next door neighbors and your friends. Whether you have basic checking, cash management, or investment needs, Bank First can provide quality financial products for your business to prosper. Let us be your business partner. You'll find our people make a world of difference. Bank First, loyal to Oklahoma, loyal to you. Member FDIC.
My feet are killing me. I'm ready for a nap.
Oh, no, you forgot to drop off the taxes.
How did you know?
Because they're on the table.
Well, I guess I'll have to run by Burgess & Burgess CPA.
Don't worry. Burgess & Burgess CPA have a website. There you go. Dad, now you're on BurgessCPA.com for all your tax help and bookkeeping needs.
Thanks, son.
And when you stop by Burgess & Burgess CPA, tell them Hayes Payne sent ya.
Crystal clear HD radio.
KMMY. Soper.
KITX.
HD2.
Hugo.
Paris. A Pain Media Group station.
My Rock 96.5 back to action. The Buffaloes up top by 17, 57 to 40. Lose control of the basketball. Silo gets it back. Wilkerson has it. Gets it to his brother Kalen. Shot by Proctor is an air ball. Going to go almost out of bounds, saved by Silo. Wild shot that's no good. Silo gets the rebound, and we're going to have a traveling call. They're going to call that against Ethan Wilkerson as he shuffled his feet down low.
I've been watching. Kalen Wilkerson, he's still doing pretty good. Ethan, he's starting to lose his legs.
Yeah, he is a little bit.
The Buffaloes have caused that.
But, man, they played the whole game. I mean,
they had not sat down.
There's been absolutely no rotation with the boys, you know, basketball team here. But, you know, you're trying to go up and beat somebody, you know. You give it all you got, and that's what those boys have done tonight.
And they play very clean, too. I'm pretty impressed with them. You don't see a whole lot of foul trouble. You don't see them, you know, jumping over there. But the Buffaloes have been more than they could handle. 57-40, 1:44 to play here.
I think the difference in the basketball game is the pressure that Hugo can put on you defensively from end to end.
No question. And then they throw the full court press at you.
Because, I mean, we talked about as Chris Akins misses a free throw and Trey Mack comes in, Grant's going to go out. We talked about how much they've struggled shooting, especially Shanklin tonight. That's been very surprising.
But, uncharacteristic.
You know, but some nights you're just off, you know.
And luckily, the Buffaloes have enough shooting depth that one or two of the Buffaloes can be off and still have an amazing night.
So Silo breaks the press, and then we're going to have a whistle and a two-shot foul with a minute and a half left. Hey, you know, here's the thing about it. When it's an 18-point game, that whistle needs to be swallowed.
They forgot that part.
Yeah.
It's a one-way swallow, too. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You need to do it on both sides of the court.
Yeah.
Not just one or the other.
Yeah, just – in fact, lose it. I mean, throw it down.
Set it on the bench.
All right, so the free throw is good.
That's going to be enough. 41. That's going to be enough for King & King Company. They're done. They're headed to the door.
Yeah. Lennox is done, too.
Yeah. Friday night here in Silo. Buffaloes lead, 58-42.
No,
133
Lennox
to play.
Is still here. That's Trey Jordan that left.
Oh.
but King's gone.
Yeah, yeah.
Antonio.
Yeah, he's gone too. That was his ride.
Probably so.
It's great to see alumni come back and support their Buffaloes.
You know, really, Shanklin right now just ripped his jersey. He is so frustrated tonight.
Well, he just hadn't had a good night shooting, and now he's going to have to go sit down.
Well,
in a hurry.
His dad is
not
going to
be happy with him at all.
No, not for ripping that jersey like that.
Well, so
see what he did? He just
I saw that. It's Superman.
Supermaned it.
I mean, but you know what? Maybe that was a bad jersey. We need to get him another one. Will he come back with the same number? We'll find out next time.
That's his dad's number, man. He will at home.
Uh-huh.
Another whistle on the play. 16-point lead for the Buffaloes. Trying to get done with this last minute here.
You think he's got a backup jersey?
I don't think so.
I was going to say, I mean, how are you going to get a backup jersey? Yeah, change numbers.
You know, I was talking to Shanklin, Dante, and asking him, you know, how does your dad treat you in relation to the other players?
Harder?
Yeah.
Much harder?
He agreed with me. Much harder.
Free throw shot's no good. 58-42, Buffs lead here, 1:03 to play. What an interesting night tonight has been.
Yeah, as Shanklin started to get up, he thought he was going back in, but
he's
coach
done.
Said, no, just move on down one.
I think he's done for the night. What do you think?
Yeah, I think so, too. You know, those sneakers that Bostic has on?
Yes.
They look like flip-flops.
I mean, love that.
They look
that.
Like those sliders.
I agree with you. If I was like looking down there, he's like in some kind of flip-flop or beach shoe, and it's just got the white over the top. And,
yeah.
But he makes them look good, I can tell you that.
Yes. All right, so right now there's 52 seconds to go, right? Hugo just wants to go home. They're up by 15 right now.
And Silo wants to play.
They want to play to the end. So Hugo's going to have to get out of this stall out the last minute mode and just go after them.
41-34 was the girls' score. Silo beating Hugo Lady Buffs. But the Buffalo boys have come right back and put this one away.
Yeah, and another 2-point bucket for Chris Akins.
Which they forgot to put on the scoreboard.
Yeah, maybe that didn't count. 60-43. Shot is up and good now. 60-45. I think she's just completely lost interest.
I said the scoreboard?
Yeah. Oh, she did do the silo points.
That's 62. Oh,
she got ours up. Maybe she was trying to beat. There we go. Now we're caught up. 62-45. 3-point shot is up, and it's an air ball. Trayvon Brown has it, and it looks like finally Silo's just going to kind of let it go. And the Buffaloes are going to pull away here, 62-45. They come up with a huge victory on the road over the Silo Rebels.
You know, that is a big victory for the Hugo Buffaloes because, you know, this was a team, a Silo Rebels team, that came in pretty confident. I mean, they've had some good success this year, and the Buffaloes were able to come in and just really take this game from the very beginning to the very end, all the way down. Got it to within 7 points. It's about as good as it got.
Yeah, and, that's the reason we wanted to come to Silo, because it's not a matchup that we see very often, and it's fairly localized. You're talking about an hour away, so it wanted to come over here, and, you know, Silo, they had a great girls team, a really good boys team. Wanted to come see how the Buffaloes matched up, and Silo girls got the better of the Lady Buffs, but Hugo coming back and taking the boys game in impressive fashion.
It was a impressive victory indeed for the Lady Buffs. They go down in defeat tonight, 40-34, and the Hugo boys come right back in a victory, 62-45. Hugo Buffaloes do play in a tournament this weekend. Looks like that's going to be an interesting tournament up in Atoka.
It really is. You look throughout the field there. There is, I think you got Medill there. You got Atoka, obviously. You got the Buffaloes. You got Broken Bow, I think, is going to be back. I mean, how many times have we seen Broken Bow this year? It seems like we've just.
All right, so we have Latta, Lone Grove, Medill, Kingston, Broken Bow, Paul's Valley, Atoka, and Hugo.
All right, so very good field there. And, you look at that, you got to look at that field and think Hugo's probably the favorite. But there's still some really good teams there to play, and I'm pretty excited about that. So
No question, the Hugo boys would love to face Kingston in the finals. That would be fun.
Yeah, that'd be a blast.
That'd be a make good for Coach Bear. Hope Coach Bear's there when we take advantage of that opportunity. It'd be interesting to see. The first round will be Thursday, Hugo Latta, and then Friday at 8:30. Is the Hugo Latta winner will take on the Atoka Paul's Valley, and then it's over on Saturday. So undefeated Buffaloes continue to roll in 2021.
Yeah, and the Buffaloes rolling right now, ranked number 3. They're 12-0. Pretty impressive victory here tonight in Silo. We'll see how they do next weekend in that tournament.
Absolutely. For Nate, Cody back at the studio, Will Smith, I'm Will Payne. This has been a presentation of Hugo Buffalo Basketball here on MyRock 96.5.
It's MyRock 96.5, but it's the Blade Runner radio show. MyRock 96.5 is the place for your Hugo Buffaloes. You can watch all the activity live, online. If you would like to watch and listen, crank it up in stereo right here at MyRock 96.5.
Little Dixie, Community Action Agency Incorporated, helping people.